Hello, and congratulations on completing your low content publishing course. In this bonus lecture, I want to share you my first-hand experience of my Kindle self-publishing success, right? And how I think about this business and what I want to run it, right? First of all, I want to give you a little background here. Before that, I never write my own book, even though I work in the technology and trading, investing, and business financing business for many years, right? I never published my own book, or I never just have anything to do with Amazon before, right? But Amazon itself, as I started early this year, I realized that Amazon itself is such a powerful automated selling machine that literally you can sell anything from that, right? A lot of people will go to the route of selling on Amazon. They want to sell the physical goods, right? They want to run the Amazon FBA business, right? They want to order from the supplier and send the product to the Amazon warehouse, store that, and let Amazon to fulfill the sales, right? To sell them, and they just actually realize of profit from that, right? But the thing is, with Amazon FBA, there are a few things, right? I don't like about Amazon FBA. First thing is, you have to have some inventory, right? Even though if you source the product from some very low cost places like China, right, you can get the price cheap, right? Your inventory cost per unit will be relatively low, right? But consider if you are buying like 100 units of the product you are sourcing from, you still have some inventory risk. That means you have to pay the money upfront, right? Not knowing that they will sell or not, or whether they will sell even with Amazon, right? But you have to pay the money upfront, right? And another thing I don't like this is about with FBA, you have to pay the shipping cost anyway, right? How many depends on how many products you source from China to US or to the Amazon warehouse, right? You will have to pay the shipping costs, and those will eat your profit from the product from this competition on Amazon, right? That's another thing I don't like. The third thing I don't like Amazon FBA is because you source a product from China or the product are made already, right? You probably don't want to spend a lot of work on to remake the product, right? Or unless you're a manufacturer, just want to make some money, right? Even if you want to remake the product, you have to your own production facility, which to most of people certainly did not exist, right? So you're literally selling the product that everybody is selling using the same method, same tactics, right? And just sell on the Amazon. If you search on the Amazon portal, you search the same product, there are thousands of competition there selling the same product, exactly sourced from the same place, maybe even the same manufacturers in China, right? But how do you win out from this if you have no edge of your product itself? You're just running some Amazon SEO, right? To try to rank out, or you can have some friends who buy your product and review your product. Those are the small tweaks to help you to sell your product. And last but not least, your product you're selling has to fulfill some problems, right? Solve some problems for people, and so that they can buy it. And for each product you're selling, it has a certain price point, price range in a person's mind before they decide to buy your product, right? So it cannot be exaggerated or selling a very expensive product, right? Like, so you are selling a one bread, right? You cannot sell a bread for very expensive prices unless there's some shortage, right? Same thing here is for other physical product. You cannot just do that. That's the things I don't like at the Amazon FBA. But if you still want to make money on Amazon, but you don't want to sell those physical product, you don't want to deal with the shipping costs, right? Or the similarity of your products, or the inventory risk, you don't want to deal with that at all. That's then selling the information product is the best thing you can do. I will tell you why. I'll give you the reason why it is, right? Because let's say information product, we're talking about the content, digital content created from your computer or from your phone, right? And shared through the internet, right? We have a different format, right? We have books, right? And we have audio, we have video, and we have courses, we have applications like software, right? Those different formats. And among those things, if you are recording a video or your music, right, you better have some musical talent, right? Otherwise, it's hard to do, right? And it's easy to sell, but it's not very easy to create, right? If you're creating a video, like you're on the winning the YouTube, right? That's another story we can talk about in other sections. But ebook, in my opinion, is the easiest way to create because everyone can write your idea. You have your own life experience you can write. You have your own story of success on certain areas or knowledge to share to educate people you can write, right? You have your feeling that you have, maybe you have a heartbroken feeling or you have a romantic love experience you want to share, you can write. Right. Even if you cannot write, you can hire someone from Fiverr to have to write your story, right? Using their own words, but your story is definitely one of the easiest format to transfer what you think in your mind. You're literally transforming your knowledge to people and sell a set of price point for that. And for ebook or the readings, right? Reading a material, online digital reading materials. Guess what? Amazon is the number one because they have a secret weapon that nobody else has. That means a Kindle readers, right? Those little readers is the same size about as your iPad, but as I said advantage that is the design for the reading, right? If you're reading your iPad after long hours, you probably your eyes will get exhausted, right? You cannot read so long because normal computer screens, even either from your iPad or iPhone, it's not good for your eyes. That's the killing point, right? If you're reading for hours, then Kindle definitely outshine in this field, right? With your ebook readers, and you can read for hours without hurting your eyes. So that's the same beauty. And so Amazon controlled 80% of the ebook market share of the entire history, right? And it has its own dedicated e-reader to read it, right? That means once you publish your own content on Amazon KDP, Kindle platform, you can distribute 80% of the market, right? And you have a dedicated device to read your content, which is the best part of it. I have tried this for myself, right? I am not I am not a very good writer myself before that, right? But I definitely read a lot, right? The thing is, as you are reading those content, you're actually getting ideas from them, right? And you read more and you can get more knowledge from that. You can absorb the knowledge, but transform it into your own language, right? That's the thing how I started learning to write my own books, right? There's definitely some technical terms, right? How to, typeside your book, or how to edit your book, or how to design your book cover. But those are small tactics you can learn. The idea here is to have something to write about. If you don't have something to write about, go read, right? Because the internet has so many things, free ebooks or some blog posts, or you can watch a YouTube video. They will tell you something you want to know or you feel connect to, right? After you're done reading those materials or done research on those topics, you have all the knowledge in your mind, right? That's the time you start writing your own word. There's a lot of help software or platform to help you. They're very inexpensive. Even Amazon itself has a lot of software to help you write the best book, right? I would suggest that when you start, you don't have to write a very long book, very thick book, like a textbook style. You don't really have to do that. You don't want to do that, nor the people want to read that kind of book, textbook. because people want to read a book to help them to, you know, if they really have some feeling, emotional feeling up and down, they want to read your book to comfort themselves, to tell them what is the right thing to do in those difficult situations or in those emotional moments, right? If they want to learn something, definitely they want to read your book and get a quick idea on how to do such things, right? If they want to start a business, they want to read your book, know how to, what the business is and how to quickly start it. They are not expecting to just read a long book, like a textbook style, unless they're a college student, probably they want to do it. If you're targeting that market, it's just another different topic, right? We're talking about low content books here. And in most cases, 15 or 20 pages or even 40 pages book is good enough, right, to convey your idea and document what you think and give people what you want to say. It's like you're facing the camera and talking about your video. It's the same thing here. You can do that, right? You're just talking to the using your pen or using your keyboard to write out your book and communicate with your audience and tell them what your idea itself might not be perfect, right? You're not the most knowledgeable person in the world in certain area, right? But what you can do is you can be the most sincere person in this field, right? Using your own word, using your own language, using your own personal feeling to write this topic and to communicate with your audience. That's the thing you can do. You can do this really well. And I promise you, if you do this really well, if you focus on this, you will definitely success in publishing your own books. My personal experience is that through the 2 months, I've read a lot of books. I even go ahead and design my own book covers, which is seem to be very hard, but it's very easy with those software and those references. You can definitely do it, and don't think too hard about it. Make it like what I do is for those book covers, I design it in very naive, very simple terms. I never use those complicated graphics because that's not the style I want to highlight, right? I want to highlight the book that is very easy to read and give people the quick idea they want to read, and at the same time amuse them, right? Because you're not just educating either finance or business, right? You want to give them the idea that this is a pleasure journey to start. This is a pleasure journey to work on, right? This is not a hard textbook that you want to read and pass the exam. That's not a thing I want to do for my publishing, and that's not a thing I want to publish for my own course or my video. I want the people to be educated and at the same time be entertained, right? So with that, I write out about 100 books and publish on Amazon, right? And those are very good. Amazon is fantastic selling machine, right? We're not just talking about launching in one single market like US or UK, right? Amazon actually sell your content across the world. I have buyers from India, I have buyers from Spain, I have buyers from all around the world, and they, almost immediately I see the result. People coming in to buy my books. I write a book, I wrote a book, and I designed the book cover, and they like it. They just like it because you are a guy who have give a sincere knowledge or sharing from yourself, right? And people love to see it. People, if you price your book in the right price point, people will love to buy it as well. And even if they don't want to buy it or they are hesitating to buy it, they can participate in the Amazon's what they call the Kindle unlimited read program, right? That means they can lend your book, they can borrow your book, and they can read it at the library style, right? And you still get paid by each page they read, right? It's just like how we earn money from the online video, right? You get paid by how many views you have, how many ads they run, right? But for KDP or Kindle, they definitely don't run the ads, right? Well, they may run, but I don't know. But you can. The point is, as an author, you can get paid by people not just buying your book. They can read your book. You still get paid, right? And if people buy your book, of course you get paid, right? And you have very good sharing sharing conversion with Amazon, I think Amazon can take, you can take at most 70% and Amazon take the 30% and do the all the work to help you to publish your book, you know, sell your book, market your book, right? And people go to the platform like Amazon, they will believe in you immediately, right? So this is a win-win situation that you definitely want to participate, right? And, the creation of the books is a creative process, right? You can definitely do it either in short term or long term, depends on how you want to do it. But the thing I will suggest is to get those books, get those content, get the product to the market as fast as you can, right? And you test out the market. If you're launching 100 books, maybe only 50 of them people will like it, people will read it, people will buy it. Another 50, you just give away on them and don't spend more time on them. That means those topics, maybe at this moment, people don't want to read about it, don't want to know about it, right? So you can focus on the other 50, right? And make it better or create similar books to those 50s. That's the thing you want to do, right? If you don't now, if you hesitate or stay too long on creating the book without getting them to the market, how would you know? How would you know people will like it, right? So that's the thing you don't want to do. And I would suggest you, yes, you should work on Amazon or Kindle as to publish your own book as low content books, right? You should definitely do that. This is one of the best passive income or digital product you can sell. And Amazon itself is a fantastic platform to sell your book. And it's easy to do it. And in this course, I cover a lot of topics to do it, and you can definitely start doing it. If you have any questions about how to publish your book and how to sell, you can definitely check out my website here, and I will be so happy to answer all your questions. Also, in my blog, I have all the knowledge you can share, and you will definitely learn a lot from that. And I think I have covered almost the most thing I want to cover on how to publish yourself low content books and make money from your book publishing business. And I hope you learn a lot from this course. And I'm Henry Zhang here. I will see you in my next course. Come on.